Hello and welcome! Silreys here, and this is my first impressions on a game called Nosgoth. It was free to play for the whole weekend on Steam, and their Founders bundles were on a 50% sale, so I finally bought into this game. Why do I say finally? Because I've been keeping an eye on this thing. It's essentially set in the world, and it's a somewhat of a sequel, in quotation marks, to the Legacy of Kain single-player game series. This is, however, not a single-player game at all. This is multiplayer only. So, yeah, and I also never played the single-player Legacy of Kain games. But yeah, so let's talk about what I thought of this game. First thing I want to mention though is that if you are buying into this game, or if you get beta access from someone, or in general just get beta access, realize that this game is in closed beta and Steam early access at the moment. Because the game is not overly crazy well optimized. For example, when you are searching for a lobby, when you are searching for a game, as in a lobby, it uses a lobby system when you are searching for a game to get into a lobby and into a game, it really eats into your bandwidth a lot. So let's say you have a bit worse internet connection and you would like to watch YouTube on a second screen or something while you are searching for a match, that is probably not going to happen. So it eats very much into your bandwidth. And I noticed a couple lag spikes here and there while playing, but let's say they were so infrequent that while I was playing with all settings at max, I was getting a good 100 frames a second. The game is very CPU intensive, that is for certain, so if you are on an old CPU, you might struggle with this thing. Core i7, Core i5 should do just fine though, there shouldn't be no worries at all if you have a gaming rig, specifically gaming rig. But as I mentioned about lag spikes, let's say that they, for me, they happened every maybe 5, maybe 7 games, and lasted for about 2 seconds. So it's hard for me to really tell that if it was just the server being laggy, which I was connected to, or if it was really on my end, on the like computer stuff being tanking up. However, what I know for sure is that it really ate into my connection when I was trying to, you know, join a game. Now let's talk about some of the gameplay itself. Oh, actually, before I get to the gameplay itself, let's answer the big question everyone always yells about, even me, including me. Because this is not going to be a free-to-play game once it gets released. So there is free-to-play game model, meaning you are you can buy stuff with real money in the game. So let's say that this, so far from what I have seen and what is in the game at the time of making this video, this is not pay-to-win game. Alright. You can buy unlocks with real money. You can buy them with the, you know, in-game currencies as well. However, you cannot straight up buy power in a sense. Because everything has a, I would say there is a negative and a positive to every single ability. Like, there is just enough difference, enough wiggle room to make, at least from what I can tell, every ability desirable in some circumstance. Some might have a bit more wide use, obviously. You can't entirely balance everything out. But same goes with all the class weaponry for humans, for example, and all that stuff. However, the only things purchasable with real money in this game are skins and boosts, and boosts simply increase the amount of XP or gold, which is the in-game currency, you get from your matches. That is not it's not paying for power, you don't get more attack power by using a boost, And also the skins, well, they just change how your character looks. Cosmetic only. So with that tackled, let's also mention how the actual purchasable system works for this game. And I actually like it pretty well. Because they use the rental system, which has been shown in many games before, but it's never gone mainstream, let's just put it that way. Like, if I want to use a different ability on a class I would like to play, I can rent it for 7 days, or I think 30 days, or I can buy it permanently. And those prices vary, obviously. Renting it for 7 days is pretty cheap and gold-wise. So if I want to just try something else, I can just rent it for 7 days, I don't need to buy it permanently for a big cost. And that is something I really enjoy about games like this, because if I feel like trying something completely new out today, I don't need to fork out a lot of gold to buying all the stuff. So if I never actually want to use it again, then it's still sitting there for me. Whereas if I rent it and find it, oh man, this is actually for me, then I can just buy it permanently after the rental is over, right? That is something, that is a system I personally really really enjoy. Some people obviously agree or disagree with me on that concept, but personally I don't see the negative of this particular system. So I like that system very much. Also, unlocking classes, because if you just get beta access or never bought any of the proper founder bundles or whatnot, you only have two classes to play, and one of them is the hunter for the human side, and one is the reaver for the vampire side of things. So, unlocking classes works in such a way that every 5 levels, the classes have their own levels, I'm talking about your account level, which goes up as you play whatever. Every 5 levels you get an artifact, which you can use to unlock one of the classes. And here, it doesn't unlock it for you, it doesn't unlock them in a linear progression system, it simply gives you an artifact token, pick one of those classes and unlock it. I like that as well, because it gives you the choice of what to do, which one seems most fun. Obviously, probably a good idea to look online for a guide or what the class does or whatnot, if you're uncertain if it would be for you. There is always that thing, obviously. Now, let's talk about actual gameplay then. The actual gameplay of this thing reminds me so much of Alien vs. Predator. It's a game I used to play a lot of, as an alien typically. Because I was never faced of actually being upside down, it didn't bother me, but, you know, running... I have been a mobility gamer for ages, okay? I like mobility in games. One reason why my most played first-person shooter was Tribes. Anyways. In here, you have the concept, similar concept as you would have in Alien vs. Predator with Marines versus Aliens. One side has weapons, ranged weapons, only. And one side has melee only. Granted, the ranged weapon guys can make melee attacks, but they are much less powerful than the vampire attacks. So essentially you have humans versus vampires. Humans have bows, crossbows, all sorts of, dual pistols on the Prophet, all sorts of things like that. On the vampire side you have claws. And every class has two abilities which can be swapped out for different kinds of stuff. And, well, in some cases three. And I quite like the system. There is enough wiggle room for everyone to find their own niche. For example, Alchemist on the human side, on the Vampire Hunter side, they can get a healing mist, which actually allows you to play the bit of a healer role as well. If that sort of thing is for you, then yeah, go for it. I mean, there is something for pretty much everyone here. You have a flying vampire, you have one which can, charge and do massive jumps into the fights. You have one which is really sneaky, that sort of things. On the human side, you have one with a charge up bow, with a proper sniper bow. You have one with a repeating crossbow. You see my point here. There is enough differences here while keeping it melee versus ranged base concept, which is kind of nice. So, vampires climb walls, do all sorts of stuff like that, although I haven't yet found a way to actually hang to the ceiling. Maybe, hopefully they add something like that, because I would love that. I would be alien all over the place, running, you know, circles inside the houses. Good old memories. Anyway. So far, my point is that, from what I can see here, the game has a lot of potential, a lot of promise. It's 4v4, know that. And maybe come upon release and game being, you know, in development for longer and all that stuff, maybe we get a bigger maps and bigger game modes as well, with like 8v8 and so on. Right now there are only two game modes. Game is in the closed beta after all. There's Siege and Team Deathmatch, and I actually at the moment cannot comment on the Siege because I've only played Team Deathmatch. But even the Team Deathmatch shows that the concept has been really taken well, this two faction concept, because you play once on both sides and there is a timer and a kill limit. For example, on the Team Deathmatch, you play once on the human side and once on the vampire side. And the round ends after 10 minutes or 30 kills, and then you swap sides, right? So you always play both sides, unless you happen to leave in the middle of the game. But this is the sort of things that I actually enjoy about the game. Like, they have gotten a pretty good concept going on here, and they seem to be sticking to it pretty well. So now we just hope that they keep that up and bring this game to the fore, because so far I'm really enjoying this thing and I'm gonna play some more of it. And I think I'm gonna do a video detailing the whole unlock and ability system specifically. And yeah, I think I'll do just that next. Thank you very much for watching. This is my first impressions of Nosgoth, and lots of this was rambling and simply talking of random things while you get to watch some gameplay. But that was the whole point, the whole idea of this video. It's like, show people some gameplay, talk over it, and tell what I like and dislike about this game. And so far, I don't have a lot of things which I dislike, which is kind of funny, because usually when I look at the game, my point is, try to find all the things you hate about the game, and then figure out, does it balance out against the positives? And I don't have a lot of negatives here. I am seeing a lot of positives, okay, but there were a couple of the issues during the weekend, which were, for example, the party system did not work, so I couldn't team up with a friend and all that stuff. But those are things which are very likely going to be fixed for the release, right? So, yeah, as said, thank you very much for watching. I'll see you folks next time, and I'm gonna give you a good tutorial on the unlocking of things.